महाराष्ट्र से, क्योंकि रूपा गांगुली मैम फिल्मों से जुड़े हुए हमारे बीच बैठे हैं। अगली जो हमारी वक्ता है वो महाराष्ट्र से हैं, जो सिनेमा के लिए जाना जाता है, मुंबई उसका आप जानते हैं राजधानी। तो हमारे बीच अब आ रही हैं श्वेता उमरे, जोरदार तालियों के साथ उनका भी अभिनंदन कीजिए।
मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जहाँ अशोक सम्राट जैसा राजा था। मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जहाँ डाल डाल पर सोने की चिड़िया को पाया जाता था। मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जहाँ हर 50 मील पर भाषा, रूप, पहनावा, मजहब बदल जाता था। मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जिसे अपने भूगोल के पहले इस ब्रह्मांड का भूगोल समझ आता था। A very frenetic morning to everyone present in the auditorium. This is code number 29 and I'll be speaking on the topic connecting India economically, geographically and culturally. I would start my say by telling that the topic has two aspects. The first aspect is connecting India to itself. The second aspect is connecting India globally. So to the first aspect, let me tell you, I personally feel that India is already a connected enough country. To support my statement, I would like to start with my example. NASA has reported recently that the sound of the rotation of Earth is Om, and we have built our culture based on the geography of our nation. That is how our geography is connected to our culture. And when I talk about culture, how can I not talk about the Char Dham, about Haji Ali Dargah, about the Golden Temple, about the beautiful churches in Goa? This heritage tourism that we have in India is developing and generating huge amount of revenue that is initially helping us build the economy for this nation. So that is how culture is connected to economy of India. Now, how economy is connected to the geography. Once we start building a good economy, once we start knowing what a good economy means to this nation, we would have not only literate but educated candidates in our nation. And these people will be better for their cultures, they'll build better cultures, and they will take care of their geography. So this is how India is already connected to itself. Moving ahead to the second aspect of my speech, how is India connected to other countries? Well, India has always been a nation that has been rich in natural resources and cultivable land and God knows what not. And you, my dear people, the energetic youth of this nation. And that is why superpowers like US want to invest in us on our land. When they come to US, they bring huge geographical interest and bring huge economical profits for our nation. This is how we get connected to the world economically and geographically. Now, after this, what happens? When two countries get connected to each other geographically and economically, a change or exchange of cultures happen. We adapt their culture, they adapt our culture. So this is how India is connected economically, culturally, and also geographically with other countries. When I think about India, the people who drink water in West Bengal from the river that comes from Himalayas, the people who of Mumbai that enjoy monsoons are the monsoons that are coming from Gujarat, and we have the second largest network of roads in the world, thanks to the 3% taxpayers of this country. So I would like to say that India is already a connected nation. All we have to do, my dear friends, is to build this connection stronger, to be active towards our government, to be active towards our people, to be active towards our responsibilities, to hold hands, work harder, show the world that India is already a connected nation. And now we are trying to connect with you all. We are trying to form a basis on the basis of economy, culture, and diverse geography that we have. We're trying to bridge the gap between people and do what Indians were always born to do, to build love and to build peace. With this, I would like to end my say, Jai Hind.
So we had Shweta Umre from Maharashtra, and now we are